Bonjour, je vais vous présenter quelques faits saillants.
Hello, I'm going to tell you about a few important facts that make the difference between the SDGs in the longer story of development. I would like to focus on three and try to dispel a few misunderstandings. The first misunderstanding is the fact that the SDGs are a logical continuation of the MDGs, the Millennium Development Goals, adopted by the UN in the year 2000. From a purely chronological point of view, that's true, of course, because the MDGs cover the period from 2000 to 2015, and the SDGs 2015 to 2030. But if you dig deeper, it's actually not true. The MDGs were not negotiated. They were suggested by development agencies based on a technical OECD document, and they give a northern vision, a northern country's vision of what development should be in the South, a technocratic vision and slightly paternalistic vision that does not appear at all in the SDGs, because they were negotiated in concentric circles of countries with continuous application, implication of civil society and experts from the North and the South, and they are therefore much more legitimate than the MDGs. And the SDGs, and I think people are not sufficiently aware of this, were invented by developing countries themselves. It was people from the foreign offices of Colombia, with support from Guatemala, and then Peru, Bhutan, Mexico, which in 2011 suggested that these SDGs should be developed. These countries are specific in that they have intermediary revenues, incomes. They are neither rich nor poor, or in a sense, they are both rich and poor. They are rich countries with poor country problems, and poor countries with rich country problems. And that can clearly be seen in education, infrastructural health. There are problems to access primary health that are similar to those that would exist in very poor countries, but also problems with cancer or heart disease that exist in rich countries. And they do not have the ease of funding of richer countries, and they do not obtain the aid of poorer countries. So they decided to work on these SDGs to show that political and diplomatic initiatives were possible from countries that were not very visible in international relations, not an emerging economy, not a major power. They can speak and impose an agenda, which is very new. And they also remind us that there's this kind of emerging middle class in most countries in the world, and that these people are too often forgotten. So it's a kind of call to revise the whole construct of development, and all of that is very new. Second striking fact, the SDGs, with their hundreds of indicators and goals and targets, are first and foremost a political project with a vision of living together on the planet, a tribute to European values, largely, because the countries, with cooperation and assistance from European countries and then others, talked about the idea of international cooperation based on law, the equality of chances, gender equality, values of democracy and governance, the affirmation of which was quite difficult. There were political struggles within the negotiations of the SDGs, different visions of development. The gender equality aspect, for instance, was problematic. Universal healthcare was also problematic. Quality of chances in access to education, and symbolically in reduction of domestic income inequalities, which had been set aside by the SDGs by China and the US against the idea of Europe and Latin America, particularly Brazil and Norway. And it's only at the end
Brésil-Norvège,
et c'est the European and Latin American vision of an equal society prevailed. So there is a true political project in the SDGs, much more than just an Excel spreadsheet full of figures. So all of this creates particular obligations. The SDGs are, of course, universal, but they create specific obligations in certain countries, and first and foremost, European countries. The third important point I would like to discuss is a paradox, according to which, when these SDGs claim values in which everyone should, or at least in Europe, should identify, Europe is the union of countries where people talk about it the least. There are countries which place the SDGs high in the political agenda, but most European countries do not. Why so? I believe that it's because there's a misunderstanding. There's this idea that the SDGs are just targets for more or less poor countries, but that European countries are not concerned. This is absolutely untrue, and it's very simple to note that it is. Use this diagram here. It shows what sustainable development is. Of course, sustainable development is very difficult to define or explain, but there's this very simple graph that shows you, horizontally, you have here the IDH, the Human Development Index, that combines income, life expectancy, education, and the further you are to the right, the higher the human development, and vertically here, the ecological footprint, basically pollution, linked to the economic activity of a country. So the higher you are on the vertical axis, the more you pollute. And you can visualize that with a rectangle on the right here. You have where you could place countries that have a high HDI and a low ecological footprint. And what you can see is that no country in the world is in there. There was one 10 years ago. I'll let you guess who it was. Think about it for a second. It was Cuba. Cuba's no longer there. Cuba, for the past 5 or 10 years, has a greater ecological footprint. So no country is on the right track, but some countries are not too far, and that's the case for European countries. They are not fully sustainable, but they can ultimately access this rectangle here. So the obligations created by the SDGs for Europe seized upon by the Europeans. Of course, the path, it'll be a bumpy ride, but it is accessible. One needs to seize the opportunities created by the SDGs. So in conclusion, the SDGs are not a bureaucratic fantasy of the UN. They are a political project driven by developing nations, which want to see the rules of international cooperation rewritten. They express European values. They fought jointly with the Europeans to state these values. There are obligations for Europe to use these SDGs within and without Europe. And the ultimate conclusion is that, according to me, the value of the SDGs lies in what collectively we shall do with them.
Réside en réalité dans ce que collectivement nous en ferons.